Hello everybody, John here, and welcome back to another LEGO video. It's been quite some time, but we're back. Alright, so as I said in the last one, I was taking a little bit of a break from the LEGO stuff, just live action things, because I had a lot going on. I'm doing a bit better, you know, just emotionally and stuff like that, still a little messed up, but LEGO's been helping with that for sure. You know, I just love, you know, collecting it and then, you know, just looking at it. So, today, March 1st, as I'm recording this, I'm going to try to really get it out today, but obviously stuff takes a bit to edit, and I work today. But the Boba's Throne Room has come out, so I went to the LEGO store and I got it today. I got this and then the Luke's Hallway with the Dark Trooper attack. I might do a little video on that. I know, like, the hype has, like, kind of died down in a sense because, so many different retailers and stuff like that have already been selling the set, I think, for the past few weeks or so. Like, I know Costco's a big one, and they actually have it on sale there. But, you know, I wanted to get my VIP points, and I like supporting, you know, LEGO. I also don't have a Costco card on me, so I couldn't even go in there if I wanted to. But, you know, I was there, got in line, and then I was able to get one. It looked like I was, like, the only person there for Star Wars stuff. Some guy did buy, like, the three new helmets, which I do want to get as well because I have the rest. And I just installed little wall hangers. They're behind the camera of, like, I have the helmets on there. They were, like, 3D printed from Etsy and stuff. But they were, like, they're super fucking cool. The wall was the annoying part, just where I was screwing in. Because I was like, I want them here. But then the wall was, like, messed up. But either way, we have Boba's Throne Room. But, yeah, I know the hype's died down. And there's, like, some stuff with the set people aren't really digging or whatever, but, you know, I'm just gonna go over it, I'm gonna build it, and we're gonna just do what we normally do, which is, you know, have some fun, because that's what I'm doing this for, is that I just like to show this side of me and things like that. Alright, so looking at the box here, it's, you know, pretty good size, like, pretty big box. I think this is a good sized, set, honestly. It's probably as big as the box, I think. It's one of the thumb boxes, so there's little thumb indents there. I don't like save boxes, but because this is a Boba set and I love Boba and stuff like that, I'm probably going to keep it, honestly. And then plus it's got Boba and Fennec in the little corner right there, which I think is cool. I would technically count as like a Mandalorian set only because this is the scene where Boba walks in and kills Bib Fortuna for the throne. I really, really hope that they do, like, actual Book of Boba sets later on in the year or something like that. Because there's so much that they could do, but I feel like they're not... I feel like they're just going to miss it and not really do it, you know? Yeah, the front just has a little picture here. Basically, Boba and Fennec are coming on in. There's a Gamorrean guard. There's a Quarren, which is the Quarren is the... There's a new mold that they use for this figure. Let me see if it has the characters. It does. So there's Boba. There's Fennec. I didn't get the Moff Gideon cruiser, so this will be my first Fennec that I have, but she doesn't actually come with her helmet. Her helmet seems to only be in the Gideon cruiser right now. Probably later on, if she's in any other sets or anything like that, they'll give her her helmet, or I'll try to find the helmet by itself. I know people aren't really selling it right now, or maybe down the line, if I just have extra money or something, I'll get the cruiser. Even though it's not really my thing, but probably just for the figures. But yeah, it goes Boba, Fennec, Bib, and then this woman is a Thielen dancer. So I'm pretty sure she's one of the people that Bib has, like, dancing for him when Boba walks into the palace, or Fennec walks in. Then there's a Quarren, a Gamorrean guard, and then a Weequay guard. So there's only the three named characters there. And then just, like, random people. But I think it's, this set's $100, at least in the U.S. I used some VIP points to help with that. But I think it's just super cool. I know there's a big part that people complain about the set, and we'll get into that when we start building it. I feel like if people took a few seconds to do research or kind of realized or, like, thought for a little bit about, like, why something's a certain way, then there wouldn't be 5 million videos of people fixing the set, which kind of bother me. But either way, I think we should just get into it. I know you could take the throne out and it could be like its own thing. Little annoying that Boba's helmet and the chest piece is still a different color. I feel like they might just keep it that way because it looks like... Well, no, on here it looks kind of like the same colors and things like that. It is a little lighter. I was talking to my friend Anthony about this, and he was saying, you know, if they made the helmet darker, they couldn't really make the cheeks, like, any darker. But, you know, it'd be cool if they did, or if they just made the chest piece lighter to match it. I think that'd be cool, but let's just get into it and see what we got going on. So I'm going to try to open this very nicely. So I don't mess anything up. That's pretty good. Okay. Open her up. All right, I'm keeping you. I'm treating you very nicely. Okay. We have what looks to be 6 bags. So there's 6 bags. So this is like a good build. We got a few stickers here. These look to all be for the throne, I think. Oh no, these 2 stickers are for, let me see. There's 4 stickers, sticker types, but in total there's 6. Yeah, these ones are for the throne. These bottom down here, and then this is for the top of the palace thing, I think. And we got a thick book here too. Like, this is pretty thick. Interesting that it's like vertical like this though. But yeah, so our first bag is going to be giving us Boba, and then like a little frame. Then it's like building for those ones. We got our figures again in bag 4, Fennec and the guard in 5, and then Bib and the Quarren in 6. So I think this is going to be fucking awesome. I just cleared off. You can't see because I'm, again, if you guys know, my layout is I have a big mirror behind the camera, so I'm kind of looking to see if I'm in frame, and then if I, what you guys can see, so I change the frame up every so often. Sorry, I have the window open, I'm getting distracted because I have the attention span of a fly, but you know, I got my stuff up there, but I cleared this shelf off. This is where my Lego helmets were, and I just, you know, got the stands up there on the wall. I'll probably show it in a different video if people want to see, like, the helmets, or probably if I get the new helmets, I'll probably do a little video on those, but those probably won't be for a while because Lego costs money. But, you know, I cleared that shelf off. I'm probably going to put all my Boba stuff there because if you can kind of see, you can, like, right down there, I have, like, kind of like a Boba timeline in Lego. I have the carbon chamber, the anniversary slave one, and then the skiff with the Sarlacc with the gray Boba, which is probably one of my favorite Boba figures. I also got another cool set that I'll definitely do a video on. It's an older set, but I'm still going to do a video on it. And then I do have the newer slave one, the Boba Fett starship on my left over here. I might put that up on the shelf with it, kind of show a little timeline. But yeah, let's do this. Guys, so we finally finished building the throne room. Camera died, you know, part way through, so I will have died like just when I was trying to record this bit when I finished it, but you know, now we finished it. Super cool. I mean, I kind of already forgot what I was saying or what I had said because I was saying this whole thing and then the camera died, so I don't really know, and then it just didn't even save the stuff, so I don't know if I'm about to repeat myself. But I apologize. You know, it's a really good build. I mean, it's a lot, it's, you know, a good size, honestly. It's $100. Usually every 100 pieces is like $10 or so. So for 732 pieces, and this is, I forgot that this is my whole spiel when I say, set number 75326. So yeah, 732 pieces. Usually that would be around like $80 or so. I think what makes up for that, like, last 20 would probably be the figures, honestly. Because, I mean, the Quarren's a new mold, Bib's a new mold. I want to say the Gamorrean Guard's a little different. You know, Fennec comes with her hairpiece, and then this is the first time we see that hairpiece in, like, that pink color. Plus, like, these characters that will probably never show up again. Like, Bib Fortuna's probably not going to show up unless they make another sail barge or something. Same thing for probably, like, the guards, or, and, like, this dancer's probably never going to show up again. The Quarren might show up a few times. I'm not really sure where, but it'd be cool to, like, see him again. The palace is a pretty... Sorry, I woke up really early to go to the store. Okay. Oh, I get this. But it's a pretty nice build. You know, from the outside, obviously there's not a lot going on with the exterior because it's the exterior of Jabba's palace. I mean, there's nothing really going on there. Never, ever was. But these little, the little tower and then this little bit on the side can actually come, can actually unhook and then, like, fold in a little bit. So you can have, like, a more enclosed area if you wanted to. You know, like, on the scene. And stuff like that, similar to, like, the cantinas whenever they do those kind of things. Whether it's the Master Builder Series 1 or just any of the cantinas, they usually do that. The back of the throne room can actually open as well. So if I just go back here, it actually unhooks at this part. And so this can open up so you can gain access to the back here. There's, I'll get, like, closer up stuff, but there's, like, a little rotisserie chicken thing here. And then you can access, like, the back where there's, like, little pots and, like, I guess other, like, bottles and stuff. Oh, it's, like, the kitchen area, I guess, from the show when he fights General Clevis. So I guess that could be what that is, which is cool. The throne room also, or the throne actually slides out itself. And you can just undo this this great piece. It's probably like the Rancor Pit. And then the throne's just its own little thing. So I think that's pretty cool that you can just do that. It has a little bit of functionality to it. Again, I'll get a little closer up things. I will quickly discuss what I was mentioning before about, like, the build and, like, more importantly, like, the roof specifically. Obviously, I mean, like, one, Lego's not going to recreate the same build that they did last time with the palace and, like, having that type of roof. But also, there was a lot of controversy surrounding that build. It looked like a certain religious building. A lot of people did not take too kindly to that. So there's a big controversy to that set. So I don't really know why they would do it again. I see a lot of videos of my recommended and stuff for some reason. I don't even look up really, like, Lego videos in that sense of, like, reviews or anything. But it's like, oh, I fixed the palace, and I fixed this. Like, Lego's stupid. Like, I don't know why they did this. And it's like, you could just look it up, and then it says that. So, yeah, if you take the 2012 roof and put it on here, that's good for you. You don't need to say that you fixed it or anything. I feel like that's a little too much to, you know, say this guy did a really bad job designing it, but I fixed it for him. Like, so, it'd be like, there's more reason behind that. Like, some things Lego does, like, the reasons are a little wacky, but I feel like when it comes to stuff like this, it's like, well, yeah, that's why they didn't do it. If they did do it, though, I mean, that probably would have helped the price a little bit more, because then you have, like, that more bit to build. Although, there are these little four hinge pieces here. Usually those are for, like, you know, if you want to, like, put something on top or whatever, maybe. So, who knows? Maybe there'll actually be, like, an expansion to the throne room. Like, that'd be really cool. Or if not, you could just attach more stuff onto it yourself in that case. For example, like Sesame Street, I don't even know if you can kind of see it in frame. It's kind of more down here, so probably not. I know you can kind of see right there. I built Sesame Street a little bit ago, and on the side of Hooper's store are two, like, the pegged, like, it's like the 1x1 brick, but it has, like, the hole in it that you can, like, put those little Technic connectors in. And my theory for the longest time will continue to be that way. Excuse me, is that they're going to make the rest of Sesame Street. I mean, Sesame Street's not that long to begin with. But you can just add, like, that extra section. Like, just another building. And you can give, like, the people what they want, I guess, with that set. Where it's like, we want Grover, the Count, Snuffleupagus, and you can even add, like, Abby-Dabby and stuff like that. But, you know, so maybe, like, this is in the same vein where you can, like, add an addition to it. But, yeah, I think this is a really cool set, honestly. I really like it. I've never had, like, a Jabba's Palace or anything like that. You know, so this is my first, like, palace. It's my first Bib Fortuna. It was actually my second Gamorrean Guard. I had the original one from the, like, the very small Han Solo thing that I lost a little bit ago. Or no, I think I still have, I know where the figure is, but I don't know where, like, the rest of that set is. And then this is my first Fennec. So, this is pretty cool. Let's get a little bit more close-ups. I really hope they do more Book of Boba sets, or, like, if I'm right in any capacity, they do, like, an expansion to this, because I think it'd be really cool. to do that. I do also want to get that 2012 palace at some point, because I want to get that and like the Rancor pit and like do that, like that whole collection. I feel like on the top of that list though, because it's like there's like the palace, the Rancor pit, and the sail barge. Probably sail barge first, then the palace, then the Rancor pit. Only because I don't have a Jabba the Hutt. Anyway, focusing on this, Lego, I think it's really cool. You know, figures are really cool. That's like the biggest part of it, honestly. And then plus just like little ability to take the throne out. You can like put him wherever you want. But let's get a little bit more close up to see those details and things like that. And then we will wrap up, I guess. All right, getting closer up to the palace itself, or the throne room, whichever you wish to call it. Ouch, that was my tripod behind me falling on my foot. So we got our figures here, so we'll look at them real quick. Obviously, we have Boba, you know, same Boba Fett as the Boba Fett starship. He has his little printed head, you know, underneath his helmet, which is still really cool. Definitely use that for other things as well. If I could just focus right there, there we go. There's the man, there's Tim. So yeah, it's just the same figure there. I mean, obviously no real big of a difference. Next we'll bring over Fennec. Fennec has, you know, her same torso and things like that from the Gideon cruiser. Except this time she doesn't come with her helmet. She instead comes with her hair piece. If you pop the hair off right there, sorry, Bib. If you pop the hair off, she has an alternate face where it's like a more, I guess, regular smile. But then like on the other way, it's a more devious type look, which fits because, you know, Fennec more often than not in the show really wanted to kill people, and Boba was like, no, can't do that. Moving on, we got Bib Fortuna. So Bib is actually pretty cool. He's like a custom molded head with like his, well, not the head, but you know, his like little twin tail things in the back of his like his head. So that's like a whole new piece. He's got his stick from his action figure from all those years ago. And then if we take off his little head thing, he has an alternate head. So yeah, there's just his regular face where he goes, Bawadawanga, and then you turn him around, and then there's him going, oh, you shot me. So, you know, that's his iconic, oh, you shot me face on the back there. We have Gamorrean Guard. Gamorrean Guard, this is just all one piece here of, like, the head and the torso and stuff, so it gives him, like, that bigger, like, frame. Really cool. You know, it's got a lot of detailing in that figure of, like, the face and, like, the torso and things like that. Shoulder pads are really cool. Awesome, awesome. We got the little dancer. I forget what her name is. Let me look at the box. She is a Thielen dancer. So obviously, again, she's from when they come on into the palace. Let's pop her hair off real quick, because she also has an alternate face where she's a little bit more angry and stuff like that. She got Mrs. Angry Eyes. I'll probably have to rewatch that scene to like actually see her. Like, I think she's just in the background. Because I know it's a Fennec shoots a Twi'lek free, I'm pretty sure. But, yeah, then we have the Weequay Man, where it's just, like, regular Weequay guy. You know, this is the first time he's in, like, a set like this, though. Like, they don't really repeat Weequay dudes, so there's, like, a new guy. Just hanging out, I guess. And then we have the Quarren, which is a really cool figure. Again, this is, like, you know, uniquely molded just for this set. And he's kind of just chilling in the background and things like that. So, those are the our figures that we got. Awesome selection. Again, I think that's like really why the price point is what it is because of the figures. Because, I mean, you get Fennec. I mean, like, obviously, I don't think they planned from the beginning where it's like, all right, Fennec is only going to be in the, you know, Gideon Cruiser and then this set. So it's like stuff like that. But, you know, she doesn't come with her helmet, which is a little bit of a bummer, even though she has it on, like, the little corner art there. So she's got it there. You know, maybe in a future set she'll have it or something like that. You know, Bo was more or less the same. I wish they just brightened his torso or darkened his helmet just for that little continuity or consistency there. Bib looks awesome. I think his eyes are really cool too. You know, just a really good selection of characters, honestly. All right, to the build itself, we have we'll start over on the right side with this little tower here. This is the tall tower that we always see whenever there's the establishing size of the palace and things like that. On the side here is like a little gear, and you turn that and the stairs will like flip up and throw off whoever's on the top there. I think on the box it shows the guard being thrown off here, so yeah, you can toss him away if you wanted to do that. I have a little control panel for the door here, so if we just switch it around this way,
a little snake there. Spooky. There's a turret gun here. You know, it's probably like moves or, you know, whoever's coming on in. But we have the little sensor like ish device, like the little eye droid that pops out. And it looks at R2 and 3PO, and I think it says, like, Uchuba Blinky, or, like, something like that. So it, like, pops on out, does that, and then the door will slide on up. Well, it would help if this was inside, so door slides on up, and then you can enter on into the palace. And for Boba to take over his planet. I was going to say, he does kind of take over the planet, in a sense. Again, here's those connector things. Not really sure what they're there for, unless it was, like, intended that way, but they are in an angle where it'd be a little difficult. Like, I don't know. Like, that's the thing. That's what's throwing me off there, is I wonder why they did that. But we will slide these guys over, and I will open this. So, yeah, now we have access to the back here. We have, like, a little kitchen area. There's a little control panel right there. Some bones in a bin. We have our rotisserie chicken right here to just make up some nice din-din. We will close that up, switch us around here. So on the left side, we just have like a little tower. There's like kind of like a booth for you to hang out in and drink whatever you want. We have a little barrel up here that's full of thermal detonators, which I think is still like a really cool printed one by one like little tile. And then we have a little throne here. So there's like this little, this is like what Jabba was like sucking on. I think this is like the hookah and stuff like that. So it's like a nice little rubber piece. The throne does come on out here, so you can, again, just take this little part off here and then have the throne. We have stuff hidden underneath the throne, which are a few blasters, and it looks like some Beskar, because that's, like, what's used in the Mandalorian Forge is Beskar, so maybe that's just, like, you know, just treasure in general. And then on the throne here, if we turn the switch, this little bottom part's going to come on up, so if Bib's sitting on there and Boba shoots him, he's going to fly off the throne, like how Boba throws him off the throne like that. And then it just slides back on in there. And then you got the palace. So this is a really cool set. Again, it was like $100, but I used some of my VIP points to get this, as well as the Luke Dark Trooper attack, like hallway type thing. So it was like $80 or whatever. It wasn't that big of a deal for these two sets. But I'll probably do a little video on that one as well. It's obviously a smaller set, but for $100, I think it's pretty worth it. I am pretty biased, obviously, because I'm a huge Boba guy. I mean, I'm wearing the shirt, you know, for the Boba Fett fan club and all that. But yeah, so this was the Boba's Throne Room.
All right, so again, that was Boba's Throne Room. Just came out today, March 1st. I'm not going to sure if I have time to edit this before I have to go to work later. I think it's like 2 o'clock now or something, or 2 or 3 or whatever, and then I have to leave around 3:30-ish. So, yeah, thick book here. I want to see if it shows any of the new stuff in the back, actually. I don't think it does, which is... Yeah, it actually doesn't show any of the other sets or anything like that, so that's interesting. But I did also get the Dark Trooper attack. I really like those little display things like that, so I got that. Overall, I'm really happy with the set. Again, you can... say whatever you want about it, but, you know, I enjoy it. I think it's overall just, like, really cool. Again, I really hope they do more Book of Boba stuff, because they really could do a lot more, you know, with the train. You could do stuff with the Rancor, do stuff with, like, the Tuskens, of course, like, a lot of Tusken stuff. Do, like, you could do, like, Fennec spaceship and kind of, like, loop that in there, but I feel like that's more Bad Batch is when her ship first shows up. Can do stuff with like the bar where Max Rebo is, things like that. I just see that my phone is running low on battery again. So this was the set. I'm really happy with it. I'm keeping that box. Yeah, I got my Boba shirt on. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, you can like it. Definitely let me know what you think of the set. I was like responding to comments and kind of just giving my thoughts on things. I mean, this is just my opinion that I really like it. That's why I went and got it first day. But thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Let me know what you want to see, if you see any cool Lego stuff in the background or just want like a tour of my Lego stuff currently. I'm trying to add a little bit more up there. You can't really see because it's out of frame, but I got Batmobiles right over there. Like, it's like a whole Batman shelf. I'm going to make this little Boba shelf if I can fit everything. I have some little Star Wars stuff up there I might have to take down and move for some things. You got Jurassic, there's a lot of cool Jurassic stuff coming out this year. I'm probably going to go get some later as well, like later in the month I might grab some more Jurassic stuff, like those Camp Cretaceous ones, because I just want those. I probably won't have time or space to build them. I got the new Star Wars helmets that I want to get, like the Thor hammer, like all the different kind of stuff. So if there's anything new that just came out that you're interested in, that I coincidentally like as well, I guess. Like, I'm not going to cover any city things, I don't think. I'm not going to cover, like, Ninjago. I'm not the biggest Ninjago person. I think there's, like, one Minecraft set I want. It came out a long time ago. Like, the Ruined Portal, I think, is a really cool set. So I might get that one if you just want to see it. But, yeah, just let me know. I mean, if there's ever any cool sets coming out, I'm definitely going to look at them. But let me know if you want me to make videos out of them or even stuff that I've already built. Like, I just built a whole bunch of stuff recently. I'm in the middle of building the endgame battle. Because that hadn't come back to my store for a good time. But the endgame battle I'm in the middle of, I just completed the first bag of it. I think there's like 3 or 4 bags. So there's that one. Mandalorian Starfighter, I just did. That's a really cool set. The Mandalorian Forge. The Black Panther Dragon Flyer. So I just did those ones. I'm trying to wait for the Brothor thing to come back. You know, I want to get the big tumbler. All kinds of just stuff like that. I also want to get that new bat kit from the Batman, and then some older stuff as well. But so it's a lot of stuff, and I don't really have that much space, but we're going to try to make it work. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Catch you later.